Magicians of Reddit, what's one time where bringing up an audience volunteer didn't go as expected? Well, aside from the classic zero response to the ask for volunteers, my favorite would have to be when the audience member in question got scared, frustrated and threw the cloth I had had her hold at me and run away. One time a magician trick required 3 volunteers to give up something AMD, so the magician suggested wedding rings. At the end he joked, "Take the most expensive one." The first guy picked a ring, the second guy picked a ring, and then the third guy said, "This remaining ring isn't mine." The first guy actually took back the most expensive one. Was at a magic show on a date last year. The magician asked for a volunteer and a little girl no more than 5 runs up on stage. "Hi there, little girl. I'm, insert magician name. What's your name?"
"Catherine.
But my friends call me Katie."
"Oh.
Can I call you Katie?"
"No."
Then she ran back into the audience. Only trick done was embarrassing the magician. Not a magician. Was the audience member. I was about 9 and the magician called me up to the stage. He had a mesh bag of lemons and a $20 bill. He told me to sign the bill and he would make it appear in one of the lemons. I reached into the bag and tried to grab one from the middle, but it was sewn in a way so that all the other lemons in the bag were in their own compartment and I could only physically grab one lemon. I looked him in the face and into his microphone. I loudly asked, "Why can I only grab this lemon?" He quickly finished the trick and ushered me off stage as quickly as possible. I was at a fake ear show and he chose me to do a trick with broken glass. The setup: there was broken glass all over the floor. He would lie down on his stomach and I would step down onto his back from a stool. Unfortunately, I was drunk and absolutely unable to stand unassisted on a stool. So while he was getting ready to lie down, I stumbled off directly into the broken glass with my bare feet. They were bare because I was about to stand on the fake ear. The audience gasped. And I looked down in wonder at my totally not bleeding feet before announcing loudly, "Don't worry, guys. It's just plastic." Well, this might sound strange. I was told it was magic night at the club by a couple of my female friends. I thought it sounded cool. They insisted that I wouldn't want to go. I told them I would, and said I practice a little bit at home. They looked intrigued, and so they brought me. Before the main show started, they were looking for volunteers. So I put my hand up. He said, "Dude, it's probably not for you." I told him, "I have always wanted to get involved. So please pick me." So he did. I got brought out to the middle of the stage and sat down on the chair. From here I noticed that the crowd was mostly women. That's when the music hit, and I looked over my shoulder to see what was happening behind me. There was a half-naked fireman coming out. Turns out it was Magic Mike night. It was full of male strippers. So I just played it cool. I was in grade school when the administration brought in a magician for the students to watch in an assembly. For one of his tricks, he started by asking for 10 volunteers. After picking 10 students, he proudly said, "This will be a process of elimination. The first volunteer will have 30 seconds to pull apart these 2 rings. Then the second person will have 30 seconds. And so on until we reach the end. Should anyone be able to do it, they'll win." At this point his assistant walks into the room carrying a comically large teddy bear, like the kind Costco sells, that are like 7 feet tall. Oohs and ahs and laughs all around. "Well, let's get started," he says, and hands the rings to the first volunteer, who was a girl in my class, and go. The girl fidgets with them for 5 seconds, then hands it back to him separated. The magician just breaks character and says, "How did you do that?" She responds, "My brother has that trick. That bear had to sit in the corner of our classroom for the rest of the day." I once saw a hypnotist get soaked with water by a guy he thought he hypnotized. Halfway through the show, the guy grabs his water bottle, places his thumb across the hole, and squeezed all of the water onto the back of the hypnotist and just kept laughing. He was thrown out of the Ren Fair. This is a bit off topic, but I feel that it belongs here. My father is the son of a relatively well-known magician, and thus knows a lot of the tricks of the trade. One day he was with some friends at a place with a magician who went from table to table. When he reached my father, my dad challenged him to a somewhat duel, saying he could figure out any of his tricks. The man agrees and begins doing a mind reading trick where he accurately described every tiny aspect of my father's childhood bedroom. My dad, of course, is blown away as he had no clue how this man knew any of these things. The magician saw his face, laughed, and walked away saying, "Your dad and I are old friends. I stayed with them last week in your room. I recognized you from the pictures still up in your room." I was at a dinner for a family member and there was a magician walking around doing tricks for all the tables. When he got to my table, he did a few tricks and ended up talking to us for a bit and found out that I knew some magic tricks. He asked if I would want to do a trick for him and I said, "Sure. Shuffle the deck and while you do, think of any card you want. Stop shuffling whenever you want to." He shuffled a few times and said he was thinking of a card. I told him to tell us what it was and that whatever card it would be the 15th card in the deck. He looked at me like he knew I was bulleting him, which I totally was. But he went along with it and said his card and counted out to the 15th card. It was his card. I was dumbfounded but didn't show it and the look on his face was priceless. I was a spectator for this one. Watching a street busker tell everyone he's going to make a balloon animal for someone and asks for a volunteer. All the little kids are jumping up and down and he picks a little girl. He tells her and everyone that she's going to get a balloon dog. Then he hands her a deflated balloon and tells her she has to make it herself. Then he turns his back on her and goes into his patter talking to the audience and not watching her. It is clear from his patter that she is not supposed to be able to make a balloon dog. Nevertheless, without pause she inflates the balloon and makes a dog. Audience is cracking up until he turns around and realizes she did it. She could have been a plant. But the trick stalled out at that point and he just moved on from there, never saw how it was supposed to end. So I think it wasn't planned. How about a science trick instead? My daughter was watching a liquid nitrogen demonstration at the science center, and the demonstrator asked if any of the kids in the audience had a penny he could borrow. My daughter, who compulsively collects small objects, had apparently found a penny at some point in the day, so volunteered it with a level of enthusiasm only available to preschool-age children. She sat smiling away, Suru happy she could help out, so happy that her compulsion was useful instead of a nuisance for once. And then the demonstrator froze and shattered her hard-won penny treasure, right before her eyes. The look of shock and betrayal on my daughter's face was one of the most raw examples of human emotion I've ever seen. We tried to make it better, but all the pennies her grandparents and I had between us couldn't make it right. My wife still keeps a broken piece of that penny in her purse as a memento. Not a magician, but there was a time my father and I went to Six Flags and they had a magician performing there, and of all 100 people in the room he calls me up. I don't remember the trick 100%, but he asked if I had a handkerchief. Being like 10 years old, I didn't know what that was, so I'm looking around at the audience, at my dad and at the magician. After embarrassing myself, he asked if he could have my shoe. I do remember the trick was to make me think my shoe that he put in a box caught fire. Fearing I lost my shoe, he showed me my real shoe. Everyone laughed. We went back to ride roller coasters. Fast forward a couple months and we went back to Six Flags and went back to see that magician. Hoping for a new trick, he does the same exact one. And again, of all people, he calls me up. Initially not recognizing me, he asks if I had a handkerchief. Told him here's my shoe. He stops dead, still realizing who it was, and said, "Okay, let's get someone else to come up." And he gets me off the stage. My dad couldn't believe I did that, but he laughed about it after. Looks like I'm the magician. I was at a special 3-day camp for the freshmen at my new school. There was a talent show and I didn't really want to participate, but some new friends talked me into it. I'm up on stage and ask for a volunteer from the audience. Immediately, this guy runs up on stage and I regret participating. I met him earlier and he had some kind of mental difficulties. I'm really not sure what. I knew it was going to make things difficult, but I also didn't want to rob him of his time on stage. Particularly after they told him that he couldn't participate in the talent show to tell a joke as he wanted to. I had to change the trick and improvise something new, as it would be difficult to communicate to him what he needed to do. I made it so that he was the one doing the trick without him having to actually do much. It worked out fine in the end and he loved all the applause he got. Then he grabbed the microphone and started to tell a joke. I just let him and signaled to the audience when it was time to laugh, because it wasn't obvious what the punchline was. I thanked him, asked the audience to give him a big round of applause, gave him a souvenir, and continued my act. It all worked out in the end, but I was pretty concerned it wouldn't at a few points. The trick is never calling someone who is a real volunteer. Finally, a question I can answer. Please hold out your hand and take this card. Guy holds out his hand. No, the other one. Guy takes arm out of his jacket pocket to reveal a stump where his hand used to be. Did magic as a hobby for a while. I once did the web for someone. Turns out they had severe arachnophobia. I always ask if they're scared of spiders before starting. They said only a little bit. After the trick, they were literally in the fetal position for several minutes. Was at a magic show in Vegas and my 10-year-old cousin got called up to assist. He had to zip the magician into a tent from the outside. Afterwards, he stood in front waiting for something to happen. Well, the magician snuck out of the tent in a furry bear suit and came up behind my cousin. He then proceeded to literally scare the piss out of my cousin. Yup, he was so startled he peed his pants on stage. Needless to say, my entire party of 20 plus family members got comped buffet passes. Audience member at a hypnotist comedy show here. A lady was brought on stage and hypnotized and convinced that a handful of napkins were $100 bills. She was told that people would try to steal them, so she should hide them in the best place possible. I think the hypnotist expected to get a laugh with people stuffing them in their bra or underwear. Not this lady, though. She took her shirt off, exposed her breasts to a room full of about 100 people, tucked the napkins under her tits, then pulled her bra back down. I've studied up a bit on hypnotism, and I learned that most people won't do things that are out of character under hypnotism. For instance, you can't convince someone to murder if they're not a murderer or smoke a cigarette if they're not a smoker. So I'd guess this woman had no problem taking her tits out on stage. But it happened. Okay, this is a little tangential to the question. But one time I was hanging out with my friend who is the best sleight of hand magician I've ever met. We are outside of this dive bar and this really tall, sexy girl who's obviously been drinking a decent amount comes up to us. My friend is super hot, so she comes up to flirt with him. So he pulls out a cigarette and starts doing some tricks and this chick loses her ducking mind. The first trick he does, she just straight up screams at the top of her lungs, which is really damn loud. She does it like 3 times and then the bouncer comes up and he's laughing but says, "You gotta stop that." He turns away and I say to my friend, "OMG, whatever you do, don't stop." So he does another sequence and this woman shouts out, "Umothadakarima, suck your dick tonight. I'm losing it." And I'm just like, "Dear Lord. PLZ, do more tricks." So he does another one and she blurts out, "Ugh. You gonna get your ducking balls licked." One of the top 10 best things I've ever seen in my life. I'm not a magician, but my younger brother was called up to stage for a magic show and didn't go as the magician had expected. We were 7 and 8 at the time and were at a 4th of July celebration. Not that this is important, but we were both homeschooled and my mom had taught us the bones and muscles of the body and different stuff like that for fun. When my brother was up on stage, the magician explained that his wand was magic and would only stay straight if the correct body part was tapped by the wand and would bend like rubber if the wrong part of the body was touched. He handed my brother the wand and started off easy by asking him to touch his head, his knee, and other common parts of the body. Obviously, the wand didn't bend. Then the magician asked him to touch his radius. My brother touched it with the magic wand. It didn't bend. Then he asked him to touch his ulna. Again. Didn't bend. Then he asked to tap his clavicle. My brother touched it correctly again and the wand never bent. Eventually the magician realized that he wouldn't be able to trick this 7-year-old boy and asked him how he knew all that. My brother just said he liked to read a lot and everyone laughed and he let him walk off stage. My parents got a kick out of that. My 5-year-old daughter got the biggest laugh of the entire show when the magician announced that he'd been performing since he was a young child in 1989. She stage whispered, "1989? You should be dead by now." I was in Vegas and watched a street magician ask a group of 3 incredibly ithama drunk girls if he could perform a magic trick. One of the girls screams "Sure, lend just," and immediately throws up in her friend's purse. In the audience for a stage hypnotist, my friend was called up, along with a random woman. Hypnotist did his routine and told her my friend was her boyfriend and that he had cheated on her. Before the hypnotist could stop her, she slapped my friend across the face. Hard enough to make him stumble and nearly fall over. And he's a stocky guy close to 200 pounds. They moved on to the next part of the act very quickly. And my friend was sent back to the audience with a massive red mark on his face. My father was called on stage to secure a straitjacket for a magician. So he ties it up and gives it a few hard pulls to make sure it was tight. He then comes back to his seat after a round of applause. My family were all paying attention to the magician. But I just see my dad laughing. So this poor magician is struggling up there for around 5 minutes, getting more frustrated that he is not making any progress. He then looks down and says, "Oh, you tied it the opposite way." My dad bursts out laughing. It was hilarious. Impressively enough, the magician was still able to get out. It is a good memory. Well, I'm not a magician, but my 9-year-old self thought I was. And I'm not sure if this fits the question, but here I go. I was participating in a talent show and I decided to do a magic act with a girl helping me. She was the volunteer, but she knew how it was going to go anyways. My trick was to toss a quarter into the crowd and it would magically appear in her hands. She already had one. I thought the quarter wouldn't make a sound, but it did, and some people scrambled to pick it up. After that awkward pause, she showed her quarter. I thought everyone would say "whoa." No one did, of course. Very awkward experience. Afterwards I did the little "my thumb is coming off my finger" trick to redeem myself. I'm not a magician, but I do remember the time a magician came to our school when I was in kindergarten as part of a big assembly of some sorts. I was called up and he had a bunch of rings with me and a few other kids having 2 rings each. He said that if we rubbed the rings hard enough together, they would magically interlink with each other. I couldn't get it to work until I noticed there were clips on it. The magician walked over and noticed I was having troubles and tried to help me. He had the microphone in his one hand, and it was close enough that when I asked what the clips on the rings were for, it could be heard all over the gym. I don't remember what happened next except I was rushed off the gym floor back into the bleachers. Was once doing a few cards tricks for some walk around magic and had a guy pick a card. I knew he chose the 10 of hearts, so now it's just a matter of wowing him when I reveal it. So I hand him the deck and turned my back. I said, "Put the card somewhere in the deck." While I am waiting for him to do that, I kid you not, there is an art exhibit with a sword, and on the sword is a pierced 10 of hearts. Magicians live for moments like this. Did not expect the trick to go this way, but I threw the entire deck of cards at the art exhibit, and when they all fell to the ground, the 10 of hearts was stuck to the tip of the sword. He about pissed himself. He thought I was the greatest magician ever, and all I did was walk into a complete and total coincidence. I had a friend who volunteered for the thing left in dry ice vapor thing. So he gives it to her and she eats it. And as expected, it starts to blow smoke out of her nose and mouth. This friend, however, had a problem where she has holes in her eardrums. The magician started to freak out and damn near fainted. It was glorious. Not a magician, but I was at a show in Reno where the magician called up some dude from the audience and the guy had a heart attack while getting up the stage to get onto the stairs. I thought it was part of the show, so I kept sipping on my mimosa until they all started panicking. We were refunded for our tickets and turns out the guy died. But he was like 85, so I guess he had already lived enough of his life. I was not the magician, but I was visiting a kind of lame amusement park called Adventureland. It was pretty run down and I think the workers were a little tired of its adventure. I was sitting in maybe a 30-person audience to a magic show and it's totally cheesy. But it was hot AF outside and this place had AC. The magician goes to do his final trick and tells an audience member to choose a card. They choose Queen of Hearts. Within a minute the guy flips through his deck. Fails to find the card. Says, "Well, I guess I should have made sure I had a full deck." Says, "That's all, folks." And the curtains close. We all laughed and sat there for a few minutes. Because we all thought it was a joke. It happened in such quick succession that it had to be a joke. Nope. He didn't come back. Tada. Not a magician, but my boyfriend's father went to a hypnotist comedy show with my boyfriend's mom, his wife, and a couple of their friends. He was sitting in the audience but still managed to get hypnotized, closed his eyes and counted backwards like instructed, and bam. Doesn't remember anything from the show after that, but he apparently danced like the people on stage, yelled out when instructed, the whole nine yards. The problem was that the hypnotist told the volunteers that when they walked off the stage they would go back to normal. Well, he obviously never walked off the stage. Come the end of the show and he starts berating his wife and the hypnotist, saying he paid good money for a 10-minute show. They tried to tell him the show had been over an hour and he didn't believe any of it. His wife and friends eventually got him out and back to where they were staying, but he said he couldn't remember most of the rest of that weekend after that. Said it felt like he had lost his mind and it got fuzzy or had been blackout drunk. He refuses to go see a hypnotist now. Not a magician, but my husband ruined a Bible lesson thing when he was asked to come up and help on stage. When my husband was a kid, he was asked to be an audience volunteer on stage at a VBS, Vacation Bible School, think day camp but W Jesus, for an object lesson. It was something about how sin affects our hearts or some such topic. One kid gets asked to eat a cookie. No problem. The other kid gets asked to eat a crumbled cookie. Sure. The next kid gets a cookie that was smushed on the floor. You but whatever. He does it. The last kid, Miso, gets asked to eat a slice of raw onion. All the kids in the room lose it. His dad, who was in the audience as a volunteer to help with the camp, sees what he's being be asked to eat and groans audibly, knowing full well what would happen next. Miso took a huge bite and smiled happily. Finished the whole bit. To this day, my husband will steal raw onions from the cutting board while I'm cooking as a pre-dinner snack. TLDR, husband was supposed to be grossed out by eating a raw onion but wasn't. And something about Jesus. I bet Jesus would like onions.